Good morning, children. Hope all are doing good and fine at home. Before starting the section 3, let's recap the section 1 and section 2. It was a windy summer. Children were drying clothes on windy summer. Usha's plan was to go to bazaar. While discussing to go to bazaar, she could remember her grandfather told about the haunted hill ghost story. Usha goes to the town and purchases things. She visits her aunt Lakshmi. Symptoms of heavy rain she finds. Usha walks fast to return home. Usha caught in stinging rain. She takes shelter at the ruins. Cats, rains, thunder and lightning scare her. Usha was completely wet and she sees two small figures under the chimney. She is frightened as if they are ghosts. Usha's heart was in her mouth. She had seen without a shadow of a doubt two ghostly figures at the other side of the room and she wasn't going to remain in that ruined building a minute longer. This means that she was frightened. Heart was in her mouth. That means she was so much frightened by seeing the ghostly creatures on the other side of the room. She don't want to remain there for a minute also. She want to leave that place immediately. Let us move to the next paragraph. She ran out of her corner, ran towards the big gap in the wall through which she had entered. She was halfway across the open space when someone fell against her. She stumbled, got up, and again bumped into something. She gave a frightened scream. Someone else screamed, and then there was a shout, a boy's shout, and Usha instantly recognized the voice. The way she came in the same way she followed to come out. At that time, when she crossed halfway, she met something. She stumbled. Stumbled means she lost her balance and about to fall. And she hit with something. Bumped into something means she hit with something. And she gave a scaring scream. She shouted. And at that time what happened? Another way, she got a scream from other end also. Who is that? She heard some boy shout at the same time immediately. And she recognized the voice. Who is that? Let's see. Suresh, Usha, Binya, it's me, it's us. They fell into each other's arms so surprised and relieved that all they could do was laugh and giggle and repeat each other's names. Then Usha said, I thought you were ghosts. We thought you were a ghost, said Suresh. Come back under the roof, said Usha. They huddled together in the corner, chattering excitedly. Here, they called each other, they fell into each other's arms. They were so happy by seeing each other's face. Here, giggle means to laugh. And they laugh at each other's foolishness, how they were scared. Huddled means crowded together. They joined together and they went in the corner. And they were very excited and happy by seeing each other's face. Let's see the next paragraph now. When it grew dark, we came looking for you, said Binya. And then the storm broke. Shall we run back together, asked Usha. I don't want to stay here any longer. We will have to wait, said Binya. The path has fallen away at one place. It won't be safe in the dark in all this rain. Then we may have to wait till morning, said Suresh. And I am feeling hungry. The wind and rain continued and so did the thunder and lightning. But they were not afraid now. They gave each other warmth and confidence. Even the ruins did not seem so forbidding. After an hour, the rain stopped, and although the wind continued to blow, it was now taking the clouds away so that the thunder grew more distant. Then the wind too moved on, and all was silent towards dawn, and the whistling thrush began to sing. Its sweet broken notes flooded the rain-washed dunes with music. "Let's go," said Usha. "Come on," said Suresh. "I am hungry." Here Usha want to rush back to home, but Binyas told it is not safe to rush back now because the path is not clear. So they stayed there till morning. Here dawn means early morning. And forbidding means frightening. That is already explained in the earlier sections. And they started moving in the early morning, beginning of the day. And they saw the whistling thrush, the bird, singing very nicely. Then what happened? Let's see in the next paragraph. As it grew lighter, they saw that the plum tree stood upright again, although it had lost all its blossoms. They stood outside the ruins on the brow of the hill, watching the sky grow pink. A light breeze had sprung up. Here again, the environment has been explained, the nature has been explained here. When they were some distance from the ruins, Usha looked back and said, "Can you see something there behind the wall? It's like a hand waving." "I can't see anything," said Suresh. "It's just top of the plum tree," said Binya. They were on the path leading across the saddle of the hill. "Goodbye, goodbye," voices on the wind. "Who said goodbye?" asked Usha. "Not I," said Suresh. "Not I," said Binya. "I heard someone calling. It's only the wind." Usha looked back at the ruins. The sun had come up and was touching the top of the walls. The leaves of the plum tree shone. The thrush sat there singing. "Come on," said Suresh. "I'm hungry." "Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye, goodbye," Usha heard them calling. Or was it just the wind? Usha was turning back while going to home. She felt someone is waving hand and saying goodbye, but there was no one. Still, she had a fear that someone is calling and someone is saying goodbye. So I hope that you have understood the lesson very well. I will give all the book back exercise in PDF form. Be safe at home. Have a pleasant day. Thank you, children.